two trays and an incubator, and I put one tray of my eggs in, another tray of another guy's egg in, same incubator. My eggs got all dumpy. It's hatched out freely. So the next time I scrubbed my head and said, try it again, see what happens. Next time it came out freely. Now it could have been the feed that the chooks were getting. Because I was burying my feed, whatever's going. So that could have been one of the problems. If I get lugging birds, you could do one or two things. Wash them in warm water and put them back in the incubator and let them dry. Most of them that I've left in the incubator and let them dry themselves, they come good. You just brush the bit of stuff on them off when it's dry and they're fine. So that gets rid of that problem. Yeah.
I breed mainly waterfowl.
Yeah.
And we're talking dry fowl now.
Yeah.
Is there a difference that you would do, say, putting eggs in, say, from waterfowl in yours, than you do with the hens?
No. Exactly the same.
Right.
The consummate thing that happened to me is I had a gentleman bring me up and set up in an incubator 3 days before Christmas. I said, I haven't got one. And I've got one going. And I said, well, what have you got? And he said, oh, I've got all these duck eggs. And I said, well, 48 eggs per tray. And I said, bring us your freshest 96 eggs. And I put them in and I ran them through. And when he was picking them up, he had 75 ducklings in the box. And he said, don't want any more, and walked away. I ended up with 6 or 8 of them. Two of those died because I had work. And one of them got up and Stephen Lake showed the show and won best duck or something, or best bird in the show, even like the other one. But it was a magnificent duck. And it was the way it was brought up, the way he presented it. So it didn't make much difference, the temperature. Modern games, I'm told, need to run at a slightly lower temperature and they come out better. And this is a thing put out by a guy called Simpson, and it's about 0.5 degrees lower, we found in the modern day, that they hatched out better. But again, it comes back to what I was telling you before. Try out what works for you in your incubator. Don't be frightened to change things, right? If you think the ducks are coming out early, lower the temperature. You reckon the ducks are coming out late, increase the temperature. And maybe go from there. I find that if I roll in the duck eggs, they hatch a lot better. And in England, they have a whole lot of people who have done tests, and they just did it on duck eggs, and they found that, and they did it on nightingales, and they did it on this egg, and just all these different eggs, and they found where an egg can't be hatched when it's tilting on its head. They will hatch when they're being rolled. But the inside the egg, there's this layer of blood vessels that come around, and with a duck, if they don't join up, they won't hatch. And the same happens with all these other fancy birds that they were trying. So that they found that by rolling them, it would hatch every joint, it's more likely to join up together. That's the only thing I've ever read that's been worthwhile of. There's not a lot of information on ducks that's worthwhile.
No. I know the breeds vary. Some of them you can just about hatch in them out in the sun, but others you have a lot of trouble with. So there is a variance between the different breeds.
Yeah, there are some of the lighter ones that you can tilt on and one guy I know, he hatched duck eggs, and he said he tilted them, but instead of he turned the egg a quarter of a turn each time he tilted them, and he had very good hatch marks. I don't know.
So the ducks don't need more humidity or anything than the hen eggs.
No.
I thought the idea of an incubator was to try to image a hen as much as possible. When the hen goes off the nest, she'll go and have a feed, go back on again.
When
a duck goes off, she'll go and have a bath and get back on.
She's putting water on the eggs,
isn't she?
Yeah. Some people believe that if they've got their ducks after the first week, they spray them with an atomizer spray. And they reckon they get a better result that way.
You don't think that's necessary?
I didn't do it with this by a huge hatch I had.
No.
But then again, sometimes like this one, this woman was really chasing after them. I thought, I better try it. So I atomized them once a day on the hatching. And that was all I did. So it was, again, it's what you want to try with your incubator.
The other thing is, with a lot of incubators, you sit the egg on its pointy end down, they turn backwards and forwards. Under a hen, they're laying on their flat. And so when they're sitting up like that, how do they turn like if they would if they were under a hen? Are you better off to have them sitting flat in the incubator or sitting on their end?
Well, some hens are very good. And they'll hatch out nearly every egg. Some hens are just terrible. And they'll hardly hatch any out. And others are worse. The ones that do hatch out, they go and peck them to death. No, they just peck them.
I've had some eat them.
So they've had eggs taken out in all the kids and they hatch them.
My father-in-law ran had this little bear, and he would hatch a couple of dozen eggs each year with it. And she was precious as far as he's concerned. She lasted about 10 or 12 years doing that. So,
we've probably all got one of them.
I know one of my old neighbours had one like that, and he wasn't very impressed. He sold all of his hens only for this young lady to turn up a week later from under the house with 23 chicks. He thought he'd got rid of everything. Well, I don't know how she managed to do 26 because she was only a little OEG.
I've heard of a brown leghorn bandit. Neil Kenny told me how it might have turned up with 31 chicks. And he said, don't tell me that the eggs are no good after 10 days.
Now, I was down at Lake Parambeet fishing there one day and a mountain duck came along. She would have had 18 or 19. So again, unless they're laying two eggs a day, which I don't know, but they would have been at least 19, 20 days, probably more.
They're actually known for stealing other hens' chicks though as well. They'll steal other clutches.
This might have been the situation where the other ones they had. It's just that all the university experiments they've done and how long they've been kept sort of said 10 days is about it. They start to reduce their hatchability quite remarkably after that.
Could that be just for an incubator? That maybe a hen sitting in the wild. I've had a hen disappear and I really come up with, 15 chickens.
Yep.
And
that's possible too.
And they're all hers,
So
nature.
Yeah, that I've often thought it just must be that, you know, if it's a natural situation, the eggs probably will hatch, but in the incubator maybe not.
Look, when I store my eggs in one of these, and I have another one I'll put on top to keep the humidity up. And I have... I do that all the time. I don't have any great drama with them. And I reckon that the way you store your eggs changes them. If you put them in a carton, egg carton, it dries them out because it absorbs the water. That must keep the humidity up near 70 or 80%.
Are you turning your eggs in there?
Sorry?
Are you turning your eggs in there? No, or are you just going to sit?
Yeah, I'm dead lazy.
I've been listening to Meg Burrow and I've actually started storing my eggs in the egg carton, big end down.
Yep.
Because she was saying if you store them big end down, it actually suspends the yolk in the middle, but it helps keep the moisture in the eggs.
Yep.
Whereas if you leave the big end up, the moisture is escaping.
No, I've read about that. It's the latest thing that's actually happening. But how do you store your eggs? You know, we'll have a bearing on how long they last. I don't bother turning them or anything like that. I just sort of lay them on the side.
Chuck them in your cup on the side.
And then put another one on top so it keeps them extra.
I know people say that, like, not keeping them in the fridge and all the rest of it, but I had a fox attack at some stage, and the only hen I had left was one that was in a broody cage, of whom I was trying to break from being brooded. I didn't have any eggs at home, but I know that I'd given my mother a dozen eggs 5 days before, so I went and took the eggs back.
Out of her fridge.
She kept her eggs in the fridge all the time. I'll let them get to room temperature and put them under the hen, and I've got 9 out of 12 out.
Yeah. It's the temperature for storage of eggs is between about 4 degrees Celsius and about 21 degrees. After 21 degrees, they slowly start to develop. I had one guy who had trouble with it. He kept on bringing his eggs to me. In the end, I went down to see if I could find out what the problem was. Oh, he says, yes, I've got this little pump shed stuck out in the middle of nowhere in Derrimella. And he said, that's where I keep all the eggs. And they must have been sitting at about 25 to 30 degrees all that time. And they'd started and stopped and started and stopped and they'd just give it up. So if you store your eggs too warm, it's not good. If you store them too cold. In a fridge, the problem with a fridge is that it takes out a bit of the moisture, but some people in the fridge put them in a sealed container. If they're in a sealed container, they won't lose the moisture. And if people are running their incubator warm, at about above 4 degrees, there's no problem. They could be fine. I guess for this dinner cook now, is it?
No, still cooking.
Not for a while. Okay. Keep on going. Any other questions?
Yeah. It's interesting that you say that the feeding of the birds is so important. I didn't think that it was that important, but obviously you research that and it is. What is the best type of feed to give them then? Like this process feed, this show bird breeder, like on that ad there, it seems to be, there's so many people using that.
They're very successful in that. The Barrister one is reasonably good too. But according to a guy on a bond in Glenwolf, he said the mixture they have put a lot of meat meal in it. There's a huge amount of meat meal. They said, don't you feed a bit of meat there? I said, no. They said, but it's a vegetarian. You get a little bit of meat every now and again, and I get no problems with that way. But yes, that's a very does make a difference.
What about the stuff behind you?
Yeah, what is the stuff behind you?
Looks like a grain mix.
It's a full grain mix.
So anything like that will go well with it. It's a huge amount of variety. I mean, look at the variety of foods that humans have.